Dear student, this is a second module on mass storage systems. And in this module, we will discuss optical systems. So optical systems have different examples in which you have learned in your daily life. For example, CDs, which are known as compact disc, digital versatile disc, DVDs, and Blu-ray disc, which are also known as BDs. So normally the compact disc is 12 cm in diameter and consists of reflective material. And how the data is stored on CD or DVD, the information is recorded on them by creating variations in their reflective surfaces. So you have seen that here this is a reflective surface. So this surface, to store the data on this surface, we create slight variation. And with the help of that slight variation on this reflective surface, we can store data. And then data is stored on a single track, spiral from inside outside. So this is a different with respect to magnetic system, which you have learned in the previous module. So you can see that in CD, we are starting a spiral from here and going outward. It is going outward. But it all is called one track. So there are no multiple tracks available in CDs. So it has single track, which is spiral from inside to outside. And each track is divided into sectors. And capacity of a sector is 2 kilobytes of data, which is on which you can store 1/75 of the second audio music. So this means if you want to store 1 second of audio music, you would need about 150 kilobytes of data to store on CD. So here we come again. That data is recorded on a single track consisting of individual sectors that spirals towards the outer edge. And then how to retrieve data from there? So retrieval using a laser, and that laser can detect irregularities on the reflective surface. So we had created a reflective surface and variations in that reflective surface to store data. And with the laser, that laser can detect those irregularities to understand where is the data. And initially applied this technology applied on audio recording using format CDDA, which is called Compact Disc Digital Audio. And format is being used even today to store data on the CD. And it has single track. And there is no random retrieval. So retrieval is you want to access data from the disk. And random means you can access wherever you want to access. So for example, if I go back. So for example, if you are at the moment reading data from here, but at once you want to read data from here. So there is no random access, as it was available in the form of magnetic disc. But here the whole CD will spin. So it will spin like this in this direction. And you might have seen that when you change the track of the audio music, it spins a lot because it wants to reach at that position from where the data can be read. So it means that in CD, there is no random retrieval is possible. So this means this is one of the shortcomings of storing data on CD. And then CD capacity is 600 megabytes to 700 megabytes. So you can now calculate that 150 kilobyte you needed to store per second of data. So now you can divide 600 multiplied by 1024. So you will get the number of seconds which you can store on the CD by dividing on 150, which is for 1 second. So, however, there is a DVD which can store multiple GBs because it has multiple semi-transparent layers. So on CD there is one layer, but on DVD there are multiple layers. So laser can detect information from multiple layers. So on those multiple layers, more data could be stored. And then there is a Blu-ray disc, which are known as BDs. So BD use a blue-violet spectrum of light instead of red, which was used in CD and DVD. So which is able to focus its laser beam with very fine precision. So the data quality would be outstanding. So, and it also provide 5 times capacity than DVDs. So you can store more GBs of data on BDs. So if we summarize today's module, we have discussed one of another system of magnetic systems, which is optical system, and we have learned about CDs, DVDs and BDs and how the data is stored on them and how the data is retrieved, and we have learned that there is no random retrieval possible on CDs and DVDs.